Hey guys, this is E with Scrapbooking with Me, and as you can see, I've got a little bit of a mess around me. I am making some journal toppers is what I'm making. And I thought I would just bring you along with me. You might want to see them made, you might not. But since I was already making them and I'm right here in front of the camera, I thought I would just go ahead and turn the camera on. One I made using a piece of chipboard for the back. And as you can see, I just kind of pulled the top off of that and used the chipboard. So that's one that I've made. And I'm just using my scraps. I'm just grabbing scraps and putting them on here, whatever I can find. I've got my little HOARD box here. I actually pulled out my HOARD box. Can you believe that? These are my little doilies that have been gifted to me that I hoard. And then some lace that I hoard. So, and then more lace that I hoard. So I'm going to use some of that to make another one. I need to make quite a few of these. I don't have any left. I've used them all up. And I saw this picture in one of the little magazines or something around here. And I thought that would be a really pretty center for one. So let me decide if I want to put... Now, I try to put mine on something kind of sturdy, like I did this chipboard. But you don't have to if you don't want to. You can put it on anything. When they go on book covers, you know, old book covers, it's better to have them on something sturdy. When they go on fabric covers, you can just about put them on anything that you want. But I still like to put a good base down just so that it'll hold everything in place. So let me see what I have here that I can use for a good base. Don't know if I'll use another piece of that chipboard. I can use a piece of this. Now, I usually cut mine about, let's see, I cut them about 4, I think. What is that one? I've done forgot what I cut them. I cut them at 4 by 5.5. That's what I thought, but I wanted to make sure. So 4, and then 5.5. Now, you'll need to cut yours depending on the size of your journal cover. My journal covers are usually 6 by 9, so this is a good size for me. It still gives me plenty of room to add other things on, but yet I've still got this as my center if I want it. Some of them I put these toppers on and some of them I don't. It all depends on what I want it to look like. Now, there we go, right there. I usually go around this with some kind of ink. When it's chipboard, I go around it with white ink just to make it look like it was painted. But I'm just going to go around this one a little bit with some vintage photo. Most of this will be covered up, so it's not a big deal. But anyway, I thought I would bring you guys along. What have y'all been doing today? We have been pulling orders and getting them ready to ship out. I told one lady this morning, she had messaged me and showed me where I had made a mistake on her order. And I said, okay, if Brandon and Melina don't hurry up and get back, I'm going to go bankrupt because I've made 2 mistakes on ship outs this week. I don't know why. I guess I'm in too big a hurry. I think I'm going to use some of that lace. I think that's pretty. Now, behind this, I usually put a full piece of lace or a piece of fabric. I don't have any fabric right here on my desk, so I think I'll just grab a piece of lace. I'm just going to use a piece of this. Just something to cover this up with. You could just use a piece of book page if you wanted to. But I think I'll just put this down on it. Like I said, most all of this is going to be covered, so it's not that important. I just like lots of different layers, so that's why I do it. Not a big deal. Not a necessity. I'm almost used to all of this glue up. Then I've got another new bottle that I can start on. I can add in here. I don't like to add my new bottles on top of the old glue. And I call it old. It's not that old, but because, you know, I want all my glue that's in there to be new. So I usually wait and use every smidgen of it up. And then I put my new one in there. Alright, that will go there. And I think I want some of this. Do I want it sticking out at the top or at the bottom? Oh, maybe at the bottom. Now, I do want to put something else behind her. Okay, I've got that piece of, it's just stitched, and it's a journal sheet. It's just stitched around. I could use that. Like I said, all we're doing right now is just trying to figure out our layers. You want to make sure that you got your layers kind of down pat before you start gluing everything. I don't mind that being behind it since it's stitched, and I don't mind that little bit of chipboard showing. It's brown, so it doesn't matter. I do like that down at the bottom, I think. Now, I want something else on the top. Now, I'll tell you, this is where you can use your dimensions. So, all of those little items that, you know, are dimensional and you can't really use them inside your journals because you don't want to add that dimension to, you can definitely use it here because this is going to go on your front cover. So, let me look through my little other little hoard vault over here. I got many hoard vaults. See what I got that's dimensional. Well, we know we'll probably put a little bit of lace on there. I mean, a bling on it. Okay, I think I might like that on there. Let me see. And then there's a little piece that's got a rose in it. Like I said, this is my little hoardy vault over here, and I just kind of go through and find what I might want to add on there. Let's see, what do we think about that so far? I'm not real crazy about that on there. I don't think. I used one of these on my other one, but I think on this one I want to put something different. I like the looks of that so far. But I still feel like I need something right here. I'd like to have a little label that said, like, beauty or something like that, but I don't think I've got one. I don't think I've got another metal label at all. Well, we're going to do without the label. We are going to put this down. I'm going to start with this back piece. And I think it's already glued, isn't it? Almost. I'm just going to shove some glue under there. It's kind of, sort of glued. It's going to have everything else on top of it, so it doesn't have to be perfectly glued everywhere. As long as my corners are glued. Come on, you can get the last W out of there. That little last scrap of glue. Okay, that's glued. Now we need to put our lady down here, I think. And I'm just going to go ahead and use this glue. Just to get it used up. So put that somewhere in the middle right there. Put it a little bit further toward the top because I'm going to have that lace at the bottom. And I don't want to cover my lady up. Okay. Now, let's see. Make sure we got the right side of this. Which side's the right side? I think this is actually the right side right here. And I'm going to skip on down. Let's see. Yeah, I've got a piece right in here that's not crinkled up. And I can always use those little scraps. You don't know how much it hurts me to cut that. Okay, then we'll put her right there. Now, if you want to make these and use them on the inside of your journal, then you can. Just don't put quite so much dimension to them. You can make these little some people call them book plates, some people call them toppers. If I'm using them on my outside of my journal, I call them a topper, of course. But you can use them on the inside and, you know, use them as a little pocket. Put something behind them, a tag or something. Just going to try to pull that out straight so it doesn't look so wrinkled up. You can tell I've had that one in my hoard vault for a while because it's crinkle wrinkled. Let's try to glue that down pretty well. Now, I don't mind if it sticks over some because remember, we're putting this on the front of our journal, so not a biggie. Let's see if I can leave that laying down so I can get the rest of that glue out of there. There we go. Got that. I like that so far. Okay. Now, I need, let's see. Thought about putting that up there, this down here. Or I may just put that up there. She's got the roses here. I'd like to have that piece on, just kind of hanging off a little bit to balance everything out. What does that look like? You guys can see it better than me. What you think? I think I'm going to do it. Somebody sent me this. I don't remember who. Uh-oh, that one's got a little missing bead right there. I didn't realize that until I've already stuck it down. Maybe I can find one to stick on there. Just a little piece of bling. I'm sure I've got another in there somewhere. And then these middle pieces, of course, I put those on with my Fabri-Tac. Okay. And then I just take my towel and I dab on everything just to make sure that I don't have those little glue strings going across everything. I don't want my ladybug all covered up. And then I think we shall add, since we got the metal over here, I'm going to add this little piece of bling over here on this side. I like that. I don't think it needs anything else. What do you guys think? You gotta let me know. I don't think it does. We could put something here if we wanted to, but I think that would take away. It would need to be something pink. But I don't think I'm gonna do that. I think I'm gonna leave that just as is on that one. Let's do another one, and I'm just gonna use this little piece of, it's heavy cardstock. I'm going to do that one. And I don't know what we're going to use for the focal point yet, so let's see. 4 inches by 5 inches, or 5.5. So what do we think we can use? Now, I think I'm going to go ahead and cover this piece completely because I don't want all that white showing. So I'm just going to grab a piece of scrap paper, if I can get my hands on it somewhere. I'll just use this Edith Holden page and I'm going to cover it with that. Now this will work well on a fabric covered journal because it is bendable. You can bend this. Let's see. I think I'm just going to use the words. You won't believe everything I got pulled out on my desk. I've even got things in the floor around me. That's life, isn't it, when you start crafting. I think I have to have everything pulled out. If I don't have everything pulled out, then I forget to use things. Thank you guys for all the suggestions that you gave me last night on the video about what to call our weekly Wednesday weekly series. Thank you so much. I haven't decided yet. I've pulled all of them together, but I haven't decided exactly. It's going to have to be something that hasn't been used before. because there's so many things out there that's already been used a bunch of times. And I don't want it to be used before, so that we can find everybody's. Okay. So that looks really crooked, but I think it'll be all right. Doesn't matter if it's crooked. It's going, you know, we're going to decorate it all up. Now, what shall we do? We can put some fabric down on here if we want. We haven't done fabric yet. Let me grab a little bit of fabric. I've got some pieces of fabric here. They're just some small little pieces that I saved back to do things like this for. Maybe I have used them on a journal and maybe I haven't. But I save all these back so that I can. Let's see. I think that first one's going to be it. Now I'm going to cut, tear this. And then I'm going to try my best to cut it with my pinking shears. I'm not good at that. It's not one of my things to do, but we're going to try it. Let's see. I'm going to give myself a little bit extra in case I have to do it all over again. I think I made one of you guys' journal out of this not long ago. Okay, let's grab these things and see what I can do with them. My hands and my fingers don't work well to do something like this. I'm going to fold it and cut them both at the same time. Oh, Arthur don't let me do this very well. Now let's see if we can get this piece to uncurl so I can cut it. I'm going to go ahead and fold it again. Maybe, just maybe I can cut it like that. We shall see. It's a whole lot easier than trying to cut it all at one time. I'm probably going to have to trim it down though. I think I left myself way too much. Let's see. Yeah. We're going to have to trim it down. So let's just go ahead and chop off some. And then we shall chop off a good portion of this. I don't care if it's a little bit smaller. I think I almost cut my finger. I'm going to go ahead and glue this piece of fabric down. I'm glad I chose fabric for this one because I found, I think, a good center piece picture to go on here. You can see it in the camera, that little ballerina. That's, I think, that is like a real photo because it's not a duplicate and it's not a digital. So, thinking somebody might have sent me that. They found it at a thrift store or something like that. Okay. So we've got that down. I'm getting glue everywhere. And then, since she's the ballerina, I thought we would use a little piece of music page to put right behind her. It's thundering and lightning again. You'll probably hear it in a minute. Let's see. I think I want it that way. Yeah, because I want all of those notes there to show. You hear it? I'm telling you, we've had some more rain this week. Okay, we're going to put that down right there. Then I think my little ballerina will come next. No, I think what I want to do is I want to put a little piece of pink paper under this edge. I think. I'm going to look at it first. No, I don't think that's going to look right. Maybe at the bottom? Or at the top. See, I have to trial and error all of this like everybody else does. Alright, I think I'm just going to put a little piece at the bottom. Let that be it. I don't know why I want to pull a little bit more pink in there. I guess because she's a ballerina. I don't know. Even though she has on all white. Okay, there we go. Alright, then I've got this little piece of... I have no idea what it's called. But since she has that little tutu on there, I thought we might try to fix this where it almost looks like a little tutu. And put it down right here. Just glue it real well. I'm going to have to glue each. I could have stitched it, but I just don't want to get my needle and thread out right now. So we're going to glue it. It's going to be behind her photo anyway, this part is. So maybe, just maybe, it'll stick down well. And not interfere with her photo so much. Alright, there we go. I think we finally got it down after I got glue all over me and her too. I had to end up using my little eraser on her to get the glue off of her. Let's see if we can get her stuck down well. Okay, now I'm going to press really hard right there to just make sure that she sticks down the best we can. If I get more glue on her, I'll just use my eraser and get it off. And I did. I got more glue on her. Okay, I'll wait till that glue dries, and then I'll use my little eraser and erase all that glue that's on that photo. That's what I get for trying to use this when it's almost out. I'm getting it all over me and everything else. And then I thought I would put this little piece right down here. Maybe like that. So let's cut a little piece of this off. It's another one of my hoard pieces. Yeah, I think that'll work. It's going to take me till tomorrow to clean up all this glue. Could have used hot glue, I guess. Same difference. There we go. Okay. Like that so far. And let's see. Now, I have a couple of pieces of my faux tape. This is that tape that we made a while ago that is kind of like stained tape. You guys know what I'm talking about. For some reason, I can't talk right now. I think because I got my mind on all of this. But anyway, I've got a couple pieces of that, and I thought I would just put it down to make it look like that's what's holding her down. It's just some old tape because this is an old photo, and Just the look that I'm thinking in my head. If it works, great. And if it doesn't work, then it's just scraps. That's all I got here. Ooh, that was some thunder. And the thunder rolls. Yes, it does. Okay. So there is that. And I still feel like I need something on her. I've got this little flower that could go up that side. What do you think about that? Is that too much? Too much. Or we could just put it on top of that, but that's going to load this side real heavy. So we could put it over here. Maybe we'll do that. I don't know that that's going to look right with that stem on there, but we'll put it. Of Because they usually get flowers when they are a ballerina, don't they? Go ahead and pull that glue off of there before I forget. All right, I grabbed a charm. I think I might put that little flower charm right there. And I'm just going to... It does have that little hole where you can hang it, but I'm going to try to tuck that under because I don't want that to show, and I don't have my little pliers in here right now to cut it off. There we go. Oh, she's cute. I've got a little bit more glue on her picture. I'll get that off when it dries a little bit more, but... So there is the little ballerina topper. All right, I think that is all we will do. We've got three toppers made. I think that one's my favorite. And I usually can only make about three at a time because I take so much time deciding on what I want to do. But I'm sure that you guys can make tons and tons of them. But I may add something else on here. I feel like it's a little bit naked. But that is it. And grab your scraps out. Use your scraps because that's what I used. Basically, it's my scraps. And then from my hoard vault. All right, guys. We will talk to you later. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. Bye-bye.